But dear students, for today we'll see what do we mean by basic motions or degrees of freedom related to robot. Now it gives us the movement of robot in a three-dimensional space. So let's go with a topic, degrees of freedom, DOF, or basic motions. So here you can see the topic will be basic motions or degrees of freedom, DOF. So a definition of degree of freedom. So what does it exactly mean? So it is a term used to describe a robot's freedom of motion in three-dimensional space specifically. So it is a term used to describe a robot's freedom of motion, how it can move, freedom, how much it can move, freedom of motion in three-dimensional space specifically. Ability to move forward and backward, up and down, left and right. Okay, so there we can also define translation motion also. Motion which is going straight in a straight line, front and back, up and down, left and right. And we can also have a rotational motion also. So here, there are six DOF, that is degree of freedoms related to robot. Most industrial robots uses or utilize six axes, which give them the ability to perform a wide variety of industrial tasks compared to robots with fewer axes. So a robot which can vary with a few axes compared to that, a robot which can do its movements with six axes will be having a wide variety of industrial tasks. Six axes allow a robot move in the x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. Similarly, you can tell that in x-plane, y-plane and z-plane. So axis will give you the translation motion, planes will give you the rotational motion. Okay. So here, robot move in the x, y and z-planes as well as position itself using roll, pitch and yaw. So this roll, pitch and yaw will come when you speak about rotational motion. Next, here you can define, in this figure you can define what is your translation motion and rotational motion. So here you can see, we can make three axes. Say the axis which is showing back and forward, this is your x-axis. This is x-axis, this is x-axis you can show. And for x-axis, if you move front and back, it will give you forward and backward movement. Okay, similarly, this will be your y-axis. So here you can show your y-axis. In y-axis, if you go front and back, it will be left and right. So left and right. And this will be your z-axis. This will be your z-axis. So z-axis, if you go front and back, that is up and down. So it is a translation motion. This is up and this is down. Whatever you can show for z-axis. Now similarly, for that particular axis, if you see the rotational motion. Now say if this is your x-axis, and for this x-axis, this is the rotational motion. So it is roll, which is going to have a x-axis rotational motion. So you are showing x-axis like this. This is your x-axis, and the rotational motion is shown like this. So this is your roll. Similarly, if you see the y-axis, this is your y-axis, and here rotational motion for the y-axis is called as pitch. So here you can show this as y-axis, and the rotational motion of the y-axis you are going to show as pitch. This will be called as pitch. Similarly, for z-axis, this is the z-axis, and for z-axis you can have a rotational motion, this which you have called as yaw. So here we can show that it is a z-axis, this is your z-axis, and for z-axis you have a rotational motion which goes like this, which will be called as yaw. Okay, so here x-axis will have rotational motion as a roll, and you can have translation motion as forward and backward. This is backward. For y-axis, you can have rotational motion as pitch, and you can have the translation motion as left and right movement. And for z-axis, you can have rotational motion as yaw, And translation motion you can have up and down, up and down. So this is your x axis, this is y axis, and this is your z axis. So this is how the 6 degrees of freedom can be defined, which are the basic motions of a robot. Now here we'll go with the theory. Degree of freedom basically refers to the number of ways in which an object can move, as we have said earlier. Now simply put, that there are two basic movements. The two basic movements are translation moment and rotational moment. So this is a translation moment, which can go left and right or up and down or front and back like this. Okay, and these are rotational moments. So along that axis, if you want to rotate like this, so that will give you the rotational moment. So we can have a translation moment, and we can have 3 rotation moment. So in that case, 3 + 3 will be 6. So we will be having 6 degrees of freedom or basic motions. Then we will go to a translation motion. A translation can be further broken down into 3 kinds of movements. One is forward backward, second one is left right, and third one is up and down. So it is on x axis, y axis, and z axis. A translation envelopes along x axis. So it is forward backward along x axis. So as we have shown here, so this is forward backward. If you call the movement as forward backward, then it is on the x axis. It is also called as surge. If you are saying it is moving left and right, then it is on the y axis. It is also called as sway. If it is moving up and down, then it is on the z axis. It is also called as hey. Then a rotation can also be further broken down into 3 kinds of movements, that is roll, pitch, and yaw. If you are going around the x axis, then it is roll. If you are going around the y axis, then it is pitch. And if you are going around z axis, it is yaw. Okay, so it is yaw for that. So roll, pitch, and yaw are the 3 names for the rotational moments. So here you can see, we can show that roll will be for the x axis. This is the x axis and this is the moment. So pitch will be for y axis and this is the moment. And yaw will be for the z axis and this is the moment. Okay. So same thing again, we can show here with a plane. So here you can see roll is shown here with the x axis, pitch is shown with the y axis, and yaw is shown with the z axis. So here you can see the roll is shown here. So here you can see this is your x axis, this is your x axis, and around the x axis, if you rotate, it is roll. And then this is your y axis, this is your y axis. Around the y axis, if you rotate, it is pitch. And this is z axis, and around the z axis, if you rotate, it is yaw. Okay, so roll, pitch, and yaw will be the 3 rotational moment. So here, a rotational envelopes, you can define them as a tilting side to side on the x axis will be called as roll. Tilting forward backward on the y axis will be called as pitch. Turning left and right on the z axis will be called as y. So this will give you the rotational envelopes. Okay, so these are the 6 degree of freedom or basic motions of a robot. Okay, thank you, students.